It's a rare condition this day and age to read any good news on the newspaper page. And love and tradition of the grand design, some people say it's even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls, 'cause all I see is a tower of dreams, real love bursting out of every scene.
People walking around.
What's going on?
Guys, I can't find my Chromebook charger.
I'm not ready for the pacer test.
Can I use my phone in class?
Where is E238?
What's a cafetorium?
I forgot my ID number.
E238? Yeah, I thought not.
Can I get TikTok on my Chromebook?
Why are the seniors so tall?
I don't know what to wear. Polyester or cashmere?
I can't find my locker.
I hear the passing periods are too short.
I've given up. It doesn't exist. It can't exist. I've been everywhere.
My backpack is big enough to fit all my books.
Can I have a pencil?
I just want my mommy. Everything is so terrifying.
I've considered every possibility. It's not here. It can't be real.
Oh my god,
why
is there people walking around?
Didn't you hear? School's going fully remote this year. You don't even have to go into the building. All classes are going to be held over Zoom.
I can't do this.
We have absolutely nothing to worry about.
Except for bad Wi-Fi connections.
And confusing schedules.
And masks. What mask am I going to wear?
I'm so scared.
Look, it's right here. Sweating.
I'm so afraid.
But seriously, where is E238?
Good morning, class. Time for me to talk in a low and monotone voice for the next 80 minutes. Are you all ready? Good, let's get started. So first, we'll go over your homework on page 47. First, we have number 1, x plus 10 times
hey, you.
X minus 7. You should have distributed x and 10.
Me? No, the lump's sleeping over there. Of course you. I've got something to show you. That might make this class a little more fun.
What?
Two words. Zoom bombing.
What? No, I don't want to do that. I'll get in trouble.
Oh, come on. It's easy. Look, all you have to do is take out your phone, put a random number into Zoom, like this class's code, and bada bing, bada zoom, you can Zoom bomb. Watch this.
And that's how you solve for X. Any questions?
Yeah, I've got a question. Is your refrigerator running?
Let me check. Hey, wait a minute. Who said that? I quit.
Wow, did you see how angry they were?
I know, it's great. Why don't you give it a try?
Okay.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the administration meetings for today.
Oh, no, Piper. This is a board meeting. We can't mess with this.
Sure we can. Watch.
Mr. School Board President, I think we should extend weekends into Monday.
Hey, that sounds like a good idea.
And replace water fountains with chocolate fountains.
Yeah. Hey, wait a second. Who said that?
Your mom!
Really? Even I could have done better.
Bailey, that was amazing!
What is this feeling? I feel so alive! This is great! Let's do it again!
Hold on there, buddy. If you do it too much, they will catch on to you. You gotta pace yourself.
Absolutely not! This is the best I've felt since before COVID! I'm going to be the most famous Zoom bomber in the history of 2020.
Oh no.
Okay, students, today we're going to be learning about counting.
Hey kids, there's a boogeyman in your Chromebook.
If anyone has any objections on why these two should not get married, please speak now or forever hold your peace.
She cheated on him.
No, I didn't.
I knew it!
John was always a good dad. I'll miss him.
Man, why is it so sad here? Did somebody die?
Come on, this isn't funny anymore. You've got to stop.
You can't stop me. I'm the Zoom Bomber. I'm taking this all the way to the top.
My fellow Americans, we have finally reached peace throughout the world. No more war, no more poverty. Mission accomplished.
Launch the nukes!
Sounds reasonable. Bring me the football!
Seriously, Bailey, what have you done?
I am the greatest Zoom bomber of all time! Yes!
Hey kids, I'm your generic administrator here with a warning. Zoom bombing is dangerous. Don't Zoom bomb. The consequences could be serious.
Dear Mom and Dad, from your lonely, abandoned daughter, Lucille. The sound you're hearing is my voice that I've recorded on my phone. While you've sent me away to Grandma's house in Springfield to keep her company during quarantine, I have been keeping an audio journal to document my time in quarantine to show my future children. And also to prove to you that you should have sent me to our cousins in Sweden. Things are not going well. DGS has assigned us remote learning buddies, and I'm stuck with this obnoxious senior girl named Margot, who spends all of her time flirting with boys on Zoom.
Excuse me? Are you talking about me? I can hear you, you know. We're on the same Zoom call, and I do not do that.
4:45.
Oh, sup, Margot?
Sup, Skip.
Wanna, you know, head to a breakout room?
Ew. Well, I have to log on to PE now. I'm meeting my gym teacher today. His name is Uncle Ernie. I really hope he's nice.
All right, you guys, snap to! I don't want no spindly legged wimps. When you do your mountain climbers this afternoon, I want you to climb like the Rona is right on your butt. You hear me? My name's Uncle Ernie, and I'm in charge of showing you the power of love through athletics. You hear me? I said power. Repeat after me. Power.
Power. Power.
I said power.
Power.
Not good enough. Jumping jacks for everyone.
Good morning, freshmen, and welcome to Downers Grove South. I'm Gloria. That's, now make sure you write this down. That's G-L-O-R-I-A. And I'm your school counselor. You know, Downers Grove South is just the biggest and best public high school in Illinois. And do you know why? It's because the Mighty Mustangs created it. One day they were grazing down 63rd Street, and they said, wow, what a great place for a school.
Dear Mom and Dad, this is Lucille. Do you hate me? Grandma watches the Golden Girls and drinks what she calls her quarantinis all day. My friends have stopped texting me back, and I don't even have my remote learning buddy anymore. They caught Margot flirting in a Zoom breakout room with Skip Henderson.
Hey, Skip. This is Margot. Let's sneak out of our houses and meet at the new DGS football field.
Hey, Margot. This is Skip. Will social distancing be practiced at the football field?
Maybe. But if you want to get a little closer, I wouldn't mind.
Our love is like COVID-19. No one saw it coming, and we move fast.
Skip, that's adorable. You know, you can't spell quarantine without you are a cutie.
Quite frankly, I couldn't spell quarantine if I tried. I just know it starts with a C.
Alright guys, the Trojans got me with that oak tree, but I'm back again. You can't keep a man three athletics down for long. Today, I'd like to talk to you about, well, pain. Today we're going to play a little game called the Pain Game. What I have here are a lit candle and some hairspray. Now where did I put my blowtorch?
Good afternoon, Lucille. It's me, Gloria. That's G-L-O-I-R.
Wait, stop. That's not how you spell Gloria.
You're right, I was testing you. It's actually G-L-O-R-I-A. And I'm here with some bad news. Skip and Margot have been excommunicated from DGS. Just kidding, but they're both in serious trouble. Margot stripped her gold card and Skip has been issued 47 hours of dean detentions. Remember how important it is to maintain a safe social distancing and always wear a mask, even on Zoom.
Got it.
People, I want your attention. I'd like to apologize for what happened this morning. I've eaten broken glass on many occasions, but this is the first time I've gotten the hiccups. I would like to apologize for any emotional scarring I may have caused due to my inability to turn my camera off soon enough. But luckily, I survived. You wanna know why?
Luck?
Divine intervention?
A really good doctor?
No! Jumping jacks! Now let's get into it!
Dear Mom and Dad, this is Lucille. As remote learning continues, I'm hoping to get more involved at DGS. Maybe I can become a PE leader. They're going to need a bit more help with PE anyways. As a final athletic demonstration, Uncle Ernie jumped into this courtyard pond, blindfolded. Too bad he forgot that they filled the pond with concrete for the school's renovations. I can still hear screams echoing in my head. All in all, remote learning at DGS isn't that bad. I might actually be okay with keeping this up for the rest of the semester. Maybe. Love you, Lucille.
Look at this hilarious meme I found during math class today. Isn't it so funny? Okay, real talk. The hardest thing about remote learning isn't connecting to the internet or finding the correct Zoom link. The hardest thing about remote learning is not getting distracted while on your Chromebook. I mean, I am just a few clicks away from endless distractions, like this other hilarious meme I found. Sometimes I get so caught up, I forget what time it is. Wait a minute. Oh no! My English class starts in 5 minutes. I have to finish writing my essay on the Great Gatsby. I haven't even started it yet. Oh, I'm in so much trouble. Where's my copy of the Great Gatsby? I have to finish this paper for English class. I haven't even started it. I wonder if I can find the book on Google.
Hi, welcome to Google. Search for anything and everything you could ever possibly want with no strings attached. What may I help you search for?
Do you have a PDF of the Great Gatsby I can read?
Sure, let me check. Searching the web.
Yes! Thank you!
Results found.
Jay-Z Gatsby throws the sickest parties on the Jersey Shore. His neighbor has heard all the rumors. Gatsby killed a man. He's richer than the Blue Ivy. He's Hugh Jackman's double in the X-Men movies. Wait a minute. This isn't the Great Gatsby. Google!
Yes?
You gave me the Great Gatsby.
Isn't that what you asked for?
No.
My bad.
This is not good. I'm so stressed. Hey, I wonder if it's on Facebook.
Wait, did somebody say Facebook? Is this thing even on? Can you guys hear me? Oh, hi. Now, what do you want to look at? I suggest my grandchildren. They're so adorable. But of course, you can look at anyone. Ex-boyfriends. Let's see. Crushes, which you are definitely too young to have, little lady. Wait, do you want to look at pictures of babies? Oh, everybody posts pictures of babies on here, like my grandchildren, for example. They are just so gosh darn adorable. Did I tell you that already? Oh, you don't want to look at them? Fine. You kids don't know what good content is anyways. I guess you would want to hear about that Jenny and Mark's breakup, wouldn't you? They're on Facebook Live right now.
Thank you to all my true friends. It has just been so hard. It's been so big. I can't do this anymore. You're so toxic. I can't be around you. I can't. It's just so hard being pretty and happy. And like me, I'm such a shooter. He's the worst. I mean, he's the worst.
I don't know what you're saying, but I'm gonna like it for you, girl.
Thanks. Well, good luck on that essay, you little whippersnapper.
Oh, all right, my essay. Wasn't there something with a light? What color was that light? Blue? No, that's the color of the cover. Darn it, it's...
Why don't you try Wikipedia?
Right, Wikipedia! That's always the best place to go to find accurate information.
Hi. Welcome to Wikipedia, a collaboratively edited, multilingual, free access, free content, internet encyclopedia. Wikipedia, a mostly reliable source. Mostly.
That's all I need. Now, what color is the light in The Great Gatsby?
The light is green due to Daisy's romantic attraction to Kermit the Frog in Chapter 5.
Wait. Kermit the Frog? What was that? Kermit the Frog wasn't in The Great Gatsby.
Uh-oh. Looks like you found a Wikipedia.
What's a Wikipedia?
We at Wikipedia do encourage people to edit articles which may lead to whoopsies.
OMG. You were the main source for my essay. Oh no! What am I going to do?
I can watch this funny cat meme.
I love cat videos!
Hey kids, I'm your generic administrator here with a warning. Plagiarism is dangerous. Don't plagiarize. The consequences could be serious.
So a couple weeks ago, we started e-learning, and let me tell you, it is the easiest thing I've ever done. I'm usually so stressed about school and my grades and tests, but this year, it's totally cool. We have Zoom classes all day and we don't even have to have our cameras on. I just know this year everything is going to be fine.
Ellen, where have you been? Today's our Global Connections midterm.
What? We have a test? Oh no, I didn't study.
What were you doing?
TikTok.
You're the smartest person in class. You'll be fine.
No, I don't feel good.
You're going to get an A.
I don't know anything. All I know is what happens in the plot of Hamilton and that Aaron Burr was the damn fool who shot him. Other than that, I am completely sunk.
No, you're not.
Lewis, I know you're trying to be a friend, but I feel so helpless.
Hello, is this thing on? Good morning, class. Good morning, class. I hope you are all well rested and ready to go. I know I am. Now, you shouldn't think of this as a test. It is a test, but it's also quite a bit more. This is an assessment of learning. How you do today will determine to a large extent how you do for the rest of the course. And, of course, how you do in this class has a large impact on your overall grade point average, which is a major factor in determining what, if any, college you might be accepted into. One might say that this is your one shot at having a bright and successful future. Your future in 48 minutes. Hopefully you don't throw it away. Yes, Chris?
Are we going to be able to use a calculator?
This is history class. I don't see how that is relevant.
But can we?
Sure. Any other questions? Yes, Ellen?
Is there going to be anything about TikTok on this test?
The only TikTok you'll hear is the sound of time running out. Anything else? All right, then, let's get going. Think carefully about each question and be sure not to leave anything blank. If you studied the review sheets, you should be fine.
Review sheets?
Oops.
I didn't get any review sheets. Wait, this is Chinese. Oh no. Mrs. Williams?
Yes?
This essay question.
What about it?
It's in Chinese.
Yes?
I don't speak Chinese.
And why don't you speak Chinese?
Because I never learned it.
This may be something you want to take up with the attendance office. Do you have your documentation?
Attendance? No, I'm never absent, you know that.
Oh, what about last Tuesday?
Tuesday? Oh, that's right. I missed this period. My internet connection was terrible.
I thought so. We learn Chinese on Tuesday.
The only day I ever missed.
I am sorry, but you know the policy on making up work.
All students are responsible for all classwork missed.
You should have asked a friend.
Oops.
I am sorry, Ellen, or should I say, Ning Chok Na Kuo, Ellen.
Please, no.
Kai Fu Lin He, which means what, Lois?
Time's up. Kai Fu Lin He. Sorry, Ellen.
The other day, I told my boyfriend that I loved him. Do you know what his response was? Yuck. He responded to me saying, I love you, by saying, yuck. He said I had to come up with some other way to show him that I love him without being so yuck about it. I tried flowers, but he hates flowers because they wilt and die. I tried candy, but he hates candy because it leads to cavities and expensive dental work. So I decided that the best way to show him that I love him is to write poetry. But I know nothing about poetry. So I've decided to go undercover to this week's meeting of the Poetry Cafe and see if I can get some help. Wish me luck.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to this week's meeting of the Virtual Poetry Cafe. I'd like to introduce our returning members, Frank.
Sup.
Roberta.
Hi.
Darius.
Hello.
And we have one new member joining this week, a special guest, Abigail.
Hello.
Now I would like to open the floor to anyone who would like to share a poem. Who would like to go first?
Hi, I'm Frank, and the poetry I write is the poetry of my bone-crunching tackles. That is some dang fine versification right there. Kapow! Look, here's an original poem by me. Blue 29, set, hut, arr! Kapow, pow, pow! Tackle behind the line of scrimmage, the crowd goes bananas, and I do the dance. Then I smack talk a little. No, I say, I think I hit you so hard your mom is crying. Or, who let a bulldozer on the field? Oh, yeah.
And who's going next?
I have one poem. The title is Anguish. Anguish, torment, woe. The dark anguish of our soul is expressed in the cafeteria. Corporate food oppression, where we eat alone. Because there is no solace and this year, there is no cafeteria. Anguish, torment, woe.
Incredible. Really speaks to the kindred spirits of the virtual poetry cafe. Anyway, our last contestant for the night is Roberta.
Hi, my name is Roberta, and I enjoy sharing my work at this poetry slam. And I have a poem, and it's called My Garden Wishes. Here, in my sweet-smelling garden, with my golden butterflies dancing between my yellow sunflowers and purple violets, and the sun sending sweet kisses to my honeysuckle vines, it almost makes me think about When Satan rises again, curse humanity and damnation. And then a butterfly lands on my nose, and I forget all about that silly Satan guy.
Classic Roberta. Wonderful. A little frightening, but wonderful. And that concludes this week's meeting of the Virtual Poetry Cafe.
Wait, that kid over there hasn't gone.
That is not cool.
She probably should go before I get angry.
I didn't really prepare. I mean, I'm blank. Like, my mind is blank. Completely blank. I could be a crab crawling on the ocean floor, or a big bouquet of roses, or a red box of candy, if that's what you wanted. But you want a poem, words that say something, more than I love you. But I don't have words. I have my heart, my stupid heart, that wants nothing more than to be near your heart, for as long as you will allow it, for as long as both can be together.
Wow, isn't poetry wonderful? Thank you for sharing that poem with us. Maybe you'll let us hear from you again sometime?
Hello, and welcome back to Zoomies Through Puberty! It's the show that takes you through your most exciting, frustrating, frightening, and exhilarating moments in your life. Puberty is brought to you by Beard Rocker 2000. Hey, it may look like Peach Fuzz to everybody else, but it's a beard to a beard rocker. Let's introduce ourselves to our two prepubescent contestants. It's Stephanie Shriver.
Hi.
And of course, Tommy Landry.
Hi.
And how are you two doing on this most exhilarating new stage of your life?
Fine.
Great.
Excellent. So this is how the game works. You both will have one question and one experience, and you will be scored on how you do for both, whether it's the most embarrassing moments, hormonal hijinks, or of course, my parents will kill me. Nothing is off limits. All right, since girls go through puberty before boys, who are we to second guess nature? Stephanie, you'll go first.
Okay. I think I'll take the question to start out with.
All right, here it is. You are asked to go to the movies by Tommy Childs.
I am? Oh my God, he is a sophomore on the basketball team.
The question is, do your parents let you go?
Oh my gosh, yes, they have to let me go. They have to let me go, yes.
Alrighty, let's take a look.
No.
I'm sorry, Stephanie. Your parents say that you're way too young to start dating, and he might have been exposed to Corona. Your parents would have never let you go.
I hate them. I hate them. I hate them. Ugh.
Of course you do. It's puberty. Tommy, now it's your turn. Question or experience?
I'd better go with experience.
Your voice is going through a lot of changes, and the first time it happens, it's A, singing in the shower, B, playing Call of Duty with the guys, C, talking to Becky Casey during math class, or D, in front of your entire English Zoom class during your oral report.
D, during my oral report.
That is correct. Your voice cracks in front of your entire English Zoom class while you're doing the oral part for The Hills Are Like Elephants. Nice job!
Yes!
And Stephanie, we're back to you. It's time for your experience. Coming home late.
Oh no.
Hello, or should I say good morning?
Okay, Mom, I can explain.
12:16. 12:16 on a school night. When is your curfew?
Well, Ma.
Answer me. When is your curfew?
9 o'clock on the weekdays and 10 o'clock on the weekends.
Yes, and what are you supposed to do when you're late?
Call.
Well, I've checked my phone.
Well, Mom, we didn't leave the library until 9.
Were you at the library in Hawaii? What, you know there's a travel ban right now. You're about to quarantine for 14 days, Missy.
My life is over.
Now, Tommy, all you have to do is complete this last experience, and you are the winner! Are you ready?
I think so.
Great. Your category is the first date. Cue transition to Juliet's doorstep.
So, did you like the movie?
I told you for the fourth time. Yes, I liked the movie. Why are you acting so weird?
I don't know. I feel really uncoordinated tonight.
Why?
I guess it's because it's our first date, and I want everything to be perfect.
It's been perfect. So, here we are, at my doorstep.
Yes, here we are.
It's a little chilly out here.
Here.
I had a wonderful time tonight. I'd like it to do it again sometime.
Really? Well, bye.
And there you have it, folks. When it comes to puberty, nobody wins. Don't forget, all contestants are under medical supervision while going through puberty.
And don't forget to play Video Puberty, only for the Nintendo Switch. Switch and play. Puberty is a registered trademark of Atkins, Inc.
Hello! Jack here! David, you here?
Yeah, I'm here, Jack.
Steven, you here?
I'm here! I got my Darth Vader, my finger, ready to go.
Alright, gentlemen, I think you know why I called this meeting of the third grade junior CEO business club.
Didn't our parents just want us to hang out on Facebook Live?
No! Guys, I think it's time we discuss the possibility of us liking girls.
No way!
Gross, man.
I don't know, guys. I just have the feeling that they have a lot to offer us.
Okay, I'm uncomfortable with this, and I'll tell you why. Number one, there's the whole size thing. I mean, they're just bigger, physically taller. And number C, what's the word?
Long hair.
Disney princesses.
Smarter than we are. More advanced somehow.
Not to mention the whole cootie diss you.
Well, I think we should at least hear them out. They've sent two representatives to discuss what would be involved. Here they come now.
I am very uncomfortable with this.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Welcome to the playroom. Can I get you some Legos or something?
Thank you, no. My name's Ashley with an EY, and my daddy's a policeman. And I'm 9. This is my associate, Bethany.
I can do short division.
We understand that you are interested in, you know, liking us.
We are interested in that possibility, yes.
Excellent. Bethany?
I know how to type.
Thank you.
And I can speak French. Fromage, bacon, apple, taco, bagel.
So, what do you want from us?
Oh, your complete and undivided attention.
Well, you got it.
Boys. No, of course I do. What I mean is your complete and undivided attention until the end of time.
Uh-oh.
What do you mean, uh-oh? In accordance with the terms of agreement, we are to occupy your every thought, motivation, and decision-making process from the moment you wake up till the moment you fall asleep at night, at which time we'll play a major role in 9 out of 10 of your dreams. We do allow one wild card dream, usually a flying dream or a sports dream, which is completely up to you, of course.
Of course.
But everything else becomes, for all intent and purposes, about us. Bethany, am I missing anything?
Ah, yes! Stop doing stupid stuff!
Oh, right. And you guys will have to stop doing stupid stuff, like playing with Star Wars and making those laser beam noises with your mouths.
Yeah, okay. I am very uncomfortable with this.
Okay. With all that thought time, and no Star Wars.
No Star Wars.
What's in it for us? What could possibly be in it for us?
Well, knowledge mostly.
We already know everything. What could you teach us?
We already know everything. That one's gold.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
So if you know everything, you know where babies come from.
They come from the garden with the morning dew.
Oh my gosh.
Well, I think we're gonna need some time to think. This is a lot to consider. And we really do appreciate you coming by.
Wait, now there, of course, is a possibility that if you play your cards right, you might be able to kiss one of us.
Kiss?
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 Yes, kiss. Mwah! Well then, we must be going. Thank you for your time. We will definitely be in touch.
I can write in cursive.
Bye.
I'm sorry, old friend. All right, guys, I have to go home. Well, I'm already home. I have to comb my hair and lose some weight. Bye, guys.
Jack, how long do you think it will be? You know, before we get to kiss them?
I don't know, David. I wish I could tell you, but I just don't know.
Yeah. I don't even care.
Me neither.
My little cousin and I have very little in common. I'm into things most normal teenagers are into, like music, popular television shows, boys, but Tilly, she spends all of her free time playing Dragons and Dungeons or something. All I know is that it's weird and she's always running around the house in weird Halloween costumes when it's not even Halloween. And when it is, she dresses up as me. She says nothing is scarier than that. I can't believe her. So, parents are sick of us fighting, so she's making me play her stupid game online as a way of family bonding.
Halt! Who goes there?
What are you holding?
The blade of Wisconsinia.
What?
Wisconsinia. I got it at the Wisconsin Renaissance Fair. In case I have to battle.
Battle what?
Your face.
Can we just get this over with and play your stupid game?
Not quite yet. First, you have to meet the Dungeon Masters.
Greetings, adventurers! Thank you for joining me today. My name is Mike. We are about to venture into the world of Dungeons and Dragons, where anything can happen, and usually does.
I hate this.
What are your character names?
My name is Tilius, the Great Mage.
Cool! What about you, Starbucks girl?
I'm Agnes.
Stop being such an ignoramus, Agnes.
No, I just want to use my name, Agnes.
Fine then, it is decided. You are Agnes the Ignoramus.
That's not my name.
Agnes the Ignoramus, are you ready to begin?
Please stop calling me that.
We find our heroes in a tavern, deep in the heart of downtown Downers Grove, Balladoyle. Did you guys get the backgrounds I sent you?
Yes.
I'm not doing that.
I don't know if it's your little Starbucks drink that's making you sassy, but you need to put the backgrounds on. All right, now let's venture to Balladoyle.
I'm not doing that.
Friends, I have heard tales of your victories from far and wide. I am Stephen the Wise, proprietor of this fine tavern. Come sit, drinketh from our soda, sampleth our Trader Joe's mac and cheese bites.
How goeth you, Stephen the Wise?
Can we just skip to the quest part?
My friends, it troubles me to say, but our village has been overrun by a gang of thieves, led by an evil orc king.
Madness! They must be stopped.
A great reward awaits those brave few who lend hand to vanquishing thine enemies. Wilt thou help rid our town of such plunderers?
Of course, Stephen the Wise. What say you, Agnes?
I guess.
Suddenly, a wild bugbear enters the tavern.
What's a bugbear?
That. Be careful, they're very dangerous.
Aw, doesn't look that dangerous.
The wild bugbear does 16 damage to Agnes the Ignoramus.
Ow!
Don't let him taunt you like that. Do something.
What do you want me to do?
Get a weapon.
Does this work?
Sure.
Agnes the Ignoramus rolls a 20! A mighty 20! That blow is fatal for the bugbear!
You did it!
You defeated the bugbear! Agnes levels up, gains +1 in being less of a dummy!
Oh wait, is that really a stat?
Yep, totally is. You're less dumb! Well, thanks for letting me play, guys. I gotta go to chess practice, but I'll see you guys later.
So, was Dungeons & Dragons as geeky as you thought?
No, it is even more geeky than I thought. But playing with you wasn't nearly as bad as I thought.
Aw, thanks.
But next time we hang out, I get to be the DM.
That's what I'm talking about.
Man, I love playing Fortnite.
Me too.
Hashtag free Fortnite, am I right?
Yep, but we need a third player for a squad.
I mean, we could matchmake with a rando.
Sure, what's the worst that could happen?
Oh look, the bear's joined you again.
And his voice comes, awesome.
What up, the bears?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner, am I right? Well, hey, look what I can do. And I can do it in real life, too.
Cool.
Oh, yeah, so pretty.
Shh, guys, come here. Form up on me.
We got contact?
Yeah. We got one squad on the west side of Pleasant Park. All right, everyone, shield up. We're going in.
Oh no, there's a sniper on the craggly cliff.
Good thing he doesn't see us yet.
Noobs.
Okay, here's the plan. On the count of three, you take out the sniper. DeBears and I will take out the rest. You got that?
Mom, can I have a sandwich?
The bears, you got that?
I don't want tuna! Tuna's gross! No mayonnaise!
Hey man, turn off your mic.
I don't know.
Come on,
turkey,
turn
your
off
ham
your
or
mic.
Something. Yeah. No, not
turn
the
it
cheddar,
off.
The white American
turn off
cheese.
Your mic.
No, no baloney.
Turn off
no
your
salami.
Mic.
Okay, this is too complicated. How about
come
a
on.
Peanut butter
turn
and
turn
jelly?
Off your mic. The bears.
Not peanut butter
turn
and
it
banana.
Off.
Peanut butter and jelly.
Turn your
with
mic
the grape
off.
Jelly from the store.
Man, just
not the
turn
weird
off
apricot
your mic.
Preserves you bought.
Man, your mic's
the
on.
Weird
turn
fruit
it off.
Stand. I don't want fruit stand apricot.
Your mic
peanut
is still
butter
on.
And grape jelly.
Man, I'm backing
white
out.
White bread, not whole wheat. Whole wheat hurts my stomach.
Come on, whatever. I'm going to.
Peanut butter and jelly on white bread. It's very simple. Guys, look! Winner, winner, chicken dinner! I am so cool.
Welcome, class, to TikTok School, teaching you everything you need to know about the social media app going viral across America.
Isn't it also from China?
Let's move on, shall we? So, first things first, this is TikTok. Why don't you say so? Didn't even notice. No punches got to roll with. You got to keep it focused. You wanna say so?
We have to stop normalizing the idea that math makes sense. It doesn't make sense. It's ridiculous. At this point, I think you guys are changing the rules every time I look them up just to confuse me.
This app can get pretty weird, but people love it.
You mean like the WWE? A lot of people like it, and I really don't know why.
I know why.
Yeah, right. Exactly like the WWE. Now, to be successful on TikTok, you have to be at least one or more of these things. Cute, charismatic, cherish-mastic, talented, classy, cash-me, bougie, sassy, moody, nasty, snastam, acting stupid, TikTok. Now, I know you want to feel like you're hip with it to relate to your kids, but sorry, you're old. You are a major bummer to them.
The only hip I care about is my hip replacements.
But regardless of your age, this app can suck you in, so always remember this. If you lack self-control, hours will you scroll.
You know what I always think? We as a country need to be paying more attention. You know, back in my day, these kids would have been drafted off to war.
Now the only thing they're prepared for is World War III. Back to the lesson. There's all sorts of content on the app. Yes, you have your singers, dancers, comedy, recipes, and Jason Derulo. I mean, he's really into it. I don't get it.
I get it.
There are kids on TikTok who are driving the music industry and they can't even drive. But before you all leave class today, you have some homework. Know this dance by Monday. It's called The Renegade. Your turn.
Greetings and welcome, Mustangs, to this year's school-wide student council election. I'm Miss Brady, and I will be serving as your moderator today. Today's debate will be structured in a town hall format with questions posed by you, the students of DGS. Now please join me in welcoming your candidates for school president.
Hello, my name's Caitlin.
Hi, my name is Brittany with an EY.
Our first question comes from Dawn, who's afraid of the dark, but won't let that stop her from achieving her goals of being a cave dweller.
I love tater tots. What's your guys' opinion on tater tots?
An excellent question, Dawn. As you can see, over the last decade, school lunches have seen a disturbing decline in overall quantity of tots. I pledge to reinstate the legislation known as LOTA tots, which requires by law that all lunch trays have a tots. And with this year's remote learning, they'll be delivered right to your door.
Tots!
Contestant two, what do you have to say?
Look, I'm not gonna beat around the potato bone. Tater tots poll at 99.4%. That's a higher approval rating than ice cream trucks. In other words, if you hate tots, you hate America. And I don't hate America. Unless it's opposite day. Is it opposite day?
No, it is not opposite day.
Then I love America. My point is, the more tots, the better.
Tots!
She didn't even answer the question.
Our second question comes from Brianna Kuda, who recently ate a hot dog on camera and now has mustard on her shirt.
In recent months, there has been some debate on the veracity of the holiday icon known as Santa Claus. Where do you stand?
Thank you for your question, Brianna. First, let's be clear. Santa is real, irrefutably real. But nevertheless, it is time for some serious reform on all things Kringle. Mr. Claus outsources hundreds of good American jobs overseas to his North Pole sweatshops that violate our entire compendium of elven labor laws. And given the growing obesity pandemic, should we ignore his impudent disregard of the food pyramid?
Tots!
Look, a vote for Caitlin is a vote against free toys. And in my opinion, a vote against America.
What? I never said that.
Our final question of the evening comes from Brendan Slanderly, whose career goals include Batman.
Thank you. We live in a difficult time with difficult challenges. With that in mind, how many jumbo marshmallows can you fit in your mouth?
Come on, that's not even relevant.
Actually, the last three elections were decided by who could fit the most jumbo marshmallows in their mouth.
Well, I don't have the big ones, but I have these. I could probably fit like, I don't know, over 200 in my mouth.
This is ridiculous. All I want to do is change the world, and here we are, ignoring all the real issues and stuffing marshmallows in our mouths. Look, if you really want to change the world, if you really want to make a difference, make it with your vote. I want you to think of what that vote means. A vote for me would be a vote for leadership. A vote for me is a vote for someone who would fight tooth and nail for you. A vote for me is a vote for America. Classmates, the choice is in your hands. Your tiny, underdeveloped hands.
All right, opponent two, your closing statement.
So, basically, to sum up my campaign, if you vote for me, I will have Starbucks delivered to you every morning through Uber Eats.
And there you have it, the winner of this year's debate, Brittany with an EY.
Hello, class, and welcome to basic ninth grade math. Today we're going to be learning how to use graphing calculators. If you could all download the graphing calculator app from your Chrome web store.
Wait. A calculator app?
Yes, we'll be using this for all of our basic calculation needs.
What does it do?
Simple equations like multiplication and division.
You mean this app just does it by itself?
Yes, you enter the equation and press equal.
You knew about this app all along, didn't you? This whole time we were going through this entire charade of going with pencils and lining paper and the stupid multiplication tables. I'm sorry for shouting, but I'm a little blown away right now.
All right, students, today we're going to be doing some word problems.
Okay, so what else can you download on these things? A magical app that writes essays by itself, or some kind of automatic social studies sheet that fills it out by itself?
If a farmer has 5 acres of land a day.
Okay, so that's it then. Your math was a total farce. I'm sitting here thinking all this time, well, this stuff is pretty hard, but I guess it's useful skills to have. Meanwhile, there's this app that does it just by itself, and it can do every math problem. So why do we have to take math anyway? When am I going to use this in real life?
Just take a look.
Where am I?
Hello?
Oh my god, jeez.
There are many reasons why mathematics will come in handy. Take scenario A. Imagine that I'm a crazy person. Do this trigonometry problem, or I'll murder you.
Can I use the calculator on my Chromebook?
I have a list of necessary formulas on the screen for you.
Great. Thanks. Okay.
2 hours later.
2x equals 2 sine x co x.
That's correct. You're free to go now.
Thank goodness I paid attention in math class.
I see.
Now, on to scenario B.
Wait, what happened to everybody?
Hello, everyone. I am a very old woman and I've gone completely insane. Whoever solves this trigonometry problem fastest gets all of the money in my will.
May we use calculator?
Yes, and the necessary formulas are on the second page.
2 hours later.
Oh, is it 10 plus 50?
Congratulations! Here is all of my money.
Cool. Thanks, lady. Math rocks.
I see now that math is kind of important, so can I get some extra homework?
I knew you'd understand.
Wait, what? Parker did what in class? Okay, don't worry. I'll make sure Parker participates. Thank you. Parker,
leave me alone. This is my lunch break.
Are you playing video games right now? Okay, you're grounded from those video games until you get your grades up.
Mom, what am I supposed to do? Class doesn't start for another hour.
I don't know. Why don't you try calling your grandparents? They always say how they never hear from me anyways.
That's because they refuse to wear their hearing aids.
I don't want to hear any excuses. Either you call your grandparents or you sit in the silence for the next hour.
Fine.
Can you hear me? What? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. What's up?
Is this thing on?
What in the sand hill?
Is this thing on?
I said, what up?
Don't yell at me.
What's wrong with you? Why would you yell at your grandmother like that?
Sorry.
Well, what do you want?
I don't know. Mom says that we should hang out, so you, like, want to listen to music or something? Oh! I know. It's my favorite band. It's called Skrillex. It's pretty great.
I can't see it.
My phone broken? What's happening? Turn it off! Turn it off!
What is wrong with the kind of music that kids listen to today?
That's music? What's he making that noise with? What the? How did I get here?
It's stupid.
I'm gonna guess by the sound of your voice and the look on your face, you're not a big fan.
It's terrible.
Well, guess what? Now in the 21st century, it's considered good music.
Well, something's wrong with this world if that's good music. Back in my day, we listened to the classics like this.
I
This is horrible! I'd rather sit in silence!
I'm out of here.
You think he's coming back?
Nope!
Kids these days, they don't know real music if it hit them in the face.
This is worse.
That Shrillex was just horrible.
Hey, what do you think Frank is up to? Why don't we give him a call?
Sure.
Frank, are you there?
What?
Frank,
what?
Are you there?
What?
Frank, are you there?
Hey, I saw this new music today. It's called Shrinex.
Respectful, responsible, and engaged. Now that we're in high school, 2024, we are the freshmen, juniors, class of 2024. Word.